Welcome back to Proactive, and I'm joined now by Paul Cronin, who is the Managing Director of Adriatic Metals. Firstly, a very warm welcome to you, Paul. It's always good to see you. And secondly, we've got plenty to talk about today. I'm going to start with your quarterly activities report. So what's been going on over there?
Well, good morning. Yeah, we've released our quarterly for the first quarter of the year just on Monday. I think it was a fairly standard update of where we're at, and each quarter we try to provide a very substantive update to our shareholders on progress on construction, progress on costs, where we're seeing changes in costs or changes in scope of the project. And that quarterly update was no different. I think what we did show in this quarterly was that we're seeing costs come up a little bit, particularly on earthworks. We've been saying for, I guess, over a year now that because of higher diesel prices, we always saw the potential for increase in our earthworks costs. And so that's sort of finally coming through. But we've also shown a small delay in the project commercial production commencement date, which is largely, again, around to earthworks and slight delays and slight complications, largely caused by the terrain and also winter weather. You know, Rupice is at 1,400 metres above sea level. It is subject to substantial winter snowfall. And during the quarter, we've had 3 weeks of very heavy snow, which has delayed things a little bit. But we don't think this is a particularly material delay. And I think most importantly, we are still fully funded into production. So all in all, I think it's been a very successful quarter for us. I will send you some photos that you can share, but you know, there's been tremendous progress on site. We now have almost a full contingent of staff. We just started our last recruitment drive for a lot of our blue collar workers. We had over 800 applications for those roles. And so I think it shows that there's a lot of desire within our local community to come and work at the project. And I think generally, you know, we're very happy that everything's sort of falling into line at the right times to commence that production later in the year.
The month that you mentioned in that RNS, Paul, was November. How confident are you that it will be a November beginning for production?
Look, we have a project schedule that looks at every single task, right down to screwing in nuts and bolts in various pieces of equipment. I think where most projects are delayed, it's delays in the long lead time items. And most of our long lead time items have now arrived on site. We have a huge warehouse down the road, which is our receiving warehouse for that equipment. And we bring it up onto that site when we need it. You know, a couple of weeks ago, we had our main mill delivered onto site. And that is currently being installed into the mill building. So, you know, we're fairly confident in that. You know, you're always going to see potentially weather delays, but we're now through winter. And I think most importantly, all of our scheduling is really based on a Monday to Friday, you know, 8 to 4 working shift. We can bring in additional hours and we can start working Saturdays if we need to try and catch up on any time. So I'm very confident that we'll be able to meet that 5 November date. But also, you know, with things changing very quickly around here, I'm actually now confident we'll probably be able to bring that in a few weeks.
All right. Well, best of luck with that. Now let's look at those drill results that came out this week as well. So what is it that you think you found?
Yeah, so we've been obviously drilling Rupice Northwest, and we're getting ready to put out a maiden resource on that zone. I guess about 6 weeks ago, we were drilling a hole called BR7. We did notice some differing lithology there that warranted us pushing that hole a little bit deeper than what the interpreted mineralized zone would be. And what we've discovered there is a new zone of mineralization below the main Rupice Northwest ore body. That's thick, but it's exceptionally high grade. With grades exceeding 2,000 grams a tonne of silver equivalent over, you know, very, very mineable thicknesses. In fact, the thicknesses are largely consistent with our current stope sizing. So that creates a lot of opportunity for further growth in our mineral inventory. We have subsequently put additional holes into that zone, and they have hit mineralization. We haven't seen the assay results on those yet, but we're confident in the continuity of that zone. We have no idea what the size of it is yet, but we are very confident that it is going to increase the average grade of our Rupice Northwest zone. And more importantly, what we've done is we've started putting through holes in the area between the main Rupice ore body and Rupice Northwest. And those holes have also hit mineralization. Now, they were on the up-dip portion, which we know is typically quite thin, but as we move and we fan those lines out, we'll be drilling down in the down dip and where we typically see thicker intercepts. So that's very exciting as well. And all of this is very, very close to our existing development drive. So we're confident that these areas can be mined with minimal incremental capital costs. So it's quite exciting. But I think the high grade nature, in particular, of that lower zone in the Rupice Northwest, it does lend itself to looking at whether you would possibly ship some of this material direct without putting it through the concentrator. So that's something that we've just started to look at, and I think by our next quarterly update we'll be able to give more information on. But overall, those drilling results are indicating that yet again the mineral inventory is expanding, the mine life is expanding, and overall what we're seeing is an increasing grade rather than a reduction, which is typical when you start doing your peripheral drilling.
All right then, Paul. Well, plenty for us to be keeping an eye on. We'll let you go for now. So thank you very much for your time today, and we'll catch you again soon on Proactive.
Thank you. Appreciate your time.